You know, when you're eating, when I'm eating this kind of food, I like to see my hand, you know, so that I'll feel everything, all the flavor. When I see people using fork and knife, a spoon for food like this, I would say, why are you trying to spoil the taste of this food? You meant to use your hand to feel all the flavor. See what I get. I'm going to miss it. The first time I eat this kind of food was when I go work for Ibadan. You know, at least any of my people from Ibadan, I've lived in Ibadan for at least 5 years, you know. So when I did for Lagos, what we eat is amala. No, not amala, sorry. Eba. Eba and kind of laughing. We eat amala as well. But then, I'm not really sure what amala is like. I went to live in Badon. So when I'm at work, when I'm at break, my break time, there's one mama buka. About 5 minutes walk. 5-7 minutes walk from my shop to the place. So me and my colleagues, or can I say co-worker, we go there. In that buka place, they open at 12 and by 2. They finish selling, and then they open again at 4. You know, I don't know when they open at 4. I don't know the time they normally finish. I think they finish at 6. But by time, yes, darling. No, but you need what? Come and take it, yeah. My son needs script. Yeah, just take one packet and go. Take everything. Take that. Yeah, hold up. And when they open like that, before they open, people are start queuing. I want to do that, I like it, sir. They'll make the amala, they'll make the soup in your presence, they'll make the ewedu. Ah! And they put a goose inside the ewedu. And if you want to eat there, people that are going to eat there, they are first priority. People that are going to do takeaway, come and see plastic. Plastic will be here too. Maybe about 10 meters. You just put your plastic, or you'll be taking it, you'll be moving. Sometimes, you kill something, by the time we reach you, they'll say food don't finish. And to tell you, it's not the only place. I'm in that place. It's Songo. Anybody that live in Badon for you know Songo. Mm-hmm. Around Songo side. You know? Sometimes it will reach you like this, they'll say, oh, get it on. You want to cry. You know? And they're not the only person that sell. They are other Amala shop, another Buka. But their own is something else. God knows what they are doing to get customers like that. Or sometimes, what I normally do, I don't go for my lunch. Because sometimes when I'm too full up, I'm so satisfied. Me, okay, DJ. You know, when I'm at work, I have to go back to work because I only have 30 minutes to get back. 30 minute break. So for my shiny pen, when I go for my lunch, I eat, I drink water. Oh, there's another woman there, that's another place. I think 2 minutes to our shop, the woman only sell rice and beans and fried stew. I can eat them. But sometimes, I'll take my container, my other bum in law. So when I finish at 6, because I start at 10, I finish at 6. Sometimes I finish at 4. So I'll just go there and buy the takeaway. And I cannot wait to get home. Because the smell, the smell of the rupete. Oh my God. So I fell in love with Amala. Mm-hmm. When I'll buy 1 meat and 2 pomo. And their pomo is like this. You know those brown round pomo, those smoky pomo? I like it so much. Mama, your man do gomo like it. But in this country, you cannot find it. Remember? 2012. When I went home. Going back home after many years. When I was coming back, because the way I was eating it in the food, it was just so delicious. It was the best meal ever. And I eat it almost like every day. The other food as well, but I always go for the way my sister-in-law. Oh my God. My mother-in-law. And when I was coming, I gave my sister-in-law money to go to the market and buy me those pomo. But I was scared. I'm a custom. But I was able to escape it. So I brought it, I cook. I even buy a wedding, fresh wedding. So we wrap it inside newspaper. I'm buying a wrap it in newspaper. So I came back, I cook it for my husband. You see where my husband eats. But when they must have come, they're going to be buy it. This is the best soup ever. Most of the food. Because everything I cook, they're not from this country. I brought everything from Nigeria. I was like, no place like home. You know? Most of the food. The reason why she enjoyed it, most of the food, even if I call it Motiva. But we're Africa, Nigeria. We're not going to see that beauty. This is satisfaction. I also have tongue, yeah? Cow tongue. Yeah, huh? So good. When I was looking at the Urugu, I blend it with the Urugu because I don't have the rupete. I only have the local beans, the seed one. So I blend it with. I used to have a rupete because my mother-in-law used to send it to me. But during the lockdown, I remember when my husband came back from Nigeria in February this year. The one container. But my mother-in-law, my husband also knows that I love you so much. You look better. And the smell is something else. Since my husband goes to Nigeria, my mother-in-law sends it to me big. So I have a big container in my freezer. You know? But during the lockdown, everybody's been shopping. And because there's lockdown, we can't go out, everything. The big container, I just throw it in the bin so that I'll have space to store food. I say it's not important. If I want you, they said you here. It might not be nice as the one from home, but what can I do? You know? So you see, your common sense is mostly that it does bring you to read by lockdown. You write in the freezer. You write your cool, air, and jar. See me. Voy yo, bam, bam. Shaki. Se te ve Shaki. Que le miñamo. Timi fumi, unta mía. Unta mía. Ejo marimashai se fumi. Unta mi la jimi.